Good afternoon, YouTube. I got an email from my friend Marcy over at Learning Curve Acres asking me how to sharpen a reel mower. And she said she doesn't want to do it with an angle grinder because she doesn't have the skill and she doesn't have the PPE to use an angle grinder. Last time I sharpened this was 7 years ago, and I did it with valve grinding compound and a cordless drill. So ideally, the to be adjusted. It should slice paper quite readily. So I looked up the valve grinding compound that I have, and it's like $21 from Crappy Tire. First thing you need to do is you need to take off one wheel. Just about every push mower I've ever seen has had the wheels attached with an E-clip. Did this the last time. One of the neighbors said that his dad used to do this way as well, and that on his dad had to take off both wheels for it to be able to spin via this little shaft here, which is the actual shaft that the blades are attached. So, some mowers you only need to take one wheel off, some you need to take two wheels off, just be aware of that. Do not confuse which side the main drive gear came from. It does make a difference. Now, in here, there's a little key that slides back and forth.
Yeah, okay.
So that is what makes this gear only travel in one direction. Now on this one, just so happens that a 9/16 deep socket fits right over. Yes, 9/16. So you can spin this now quite easily by hand with a ratchet. Better case scenario would be a swivel head ratchet. Because you can use it like that. Better still case scenario And the best case scenario is a cordless drill with a socket driver in it.
Alrighty then.
So, need to bring the camera over here, Pip, to... You need to adjust these two screws in here.
And what screws?
In here.
Okay.
And they are your height gauge for the stationary blade. Quite easily do this job with the mower resting on these wheels and the handle. If you don't have a work table to set it on, but I don't like having to crouch down and work bent over on the ground. On this mower, those are half-inch bolts, and a 6mm Allen key. One nearest the shaft pushes the blade away from the stationary blade, and the one furthest from the shaft pushes the blade towards the stationary blade, pushes the stationary blade toward the rotating blade. You want a little bit of friction for this. Now, at some point in time, someone has tried to sharpen this using an angle grinder across this way, and cut it in further at this particular corner than the rest of the blade. So I'm not going to be able to adjust it to cut for the last 3/4 inch. Lock the nut. Some tension on the other bolt. And lock the nut. Now we need to do the same on the other side. Loosen the nut. That is making contact all the way across the blade. Start with, we're just going to use the ratchet on the socket. And we want to little bit. The sand embedded grease across the whole length of each of the blades. $20 for that little can, I might be a little less generous. What, that is working. Not working quite as well as actual valve grinding compound, because the sand is much quicker to break down than the grit in the valve grinding compound. See, you can't see, I can see quite a nice high polish on some of these. Blades as they come past. Remove as much of the grease as you can. You want to be really OCD about it, you could use some acetone or some brake cleaner or some rubbing alcohol. And we're just going to give that another spin. I did mention that we're doing this backwards to the rotation of the blade when it's actually in use. Sorry about that, babe. Mm-hmm. Okay, if you want to come in close with the camera, you can see the shiny polish spot along the leading edge. And then you just have to put the thing all back together again.
You don't have to change the blade distance?
No.
Okay.
Could give a dab of grease to the wheel axle. And the drive bearing, that will eventually spread itself out all the way around. Wheel water. Come on, glasses, stay on. E-clip. Could you see before?
Not really.
It's called an E-clip because it's shaped like the letter E. Dropped it. There you have it. How to sharpen a reel mower, a push mower, an old school mower, whatever you call it, with materials at hand for no money. I will leave a link to the actual valve grinding compound in the description. Sorry, it's going to be a link to crappy tire for all of my American viewers, but you can check the name and Google where to get it near you. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.